Hi guys, Kian here, and welcome back to another episode of Album Review Series. And on today's episode, we will have Japanese electronicore band Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas on their latest album, Hypertoughness. This is requested by YouTuber Fikri Harswa. And if you're excited to watch this video, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow my social media accounts. Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas is a Japanese electronicore band from Kobe that was formed in summer of 2008. The band currently consists of vocalist So, keyboardist Minami, guitarist Taiki, drummer Tomonori, and bassist Tetsuya. They are best known for their heavy use of vocoder and synthesizer blended with emo / metalcore music and rave beats. Hypertoughness is their 6th studio album. It was released on December 4, 2019 through Warner Music Japan. It is the first album to feature new bassist Tetsuya, who replaced Keiji due to his death on an acute heart failure at his home on 12th of January. So let's start the album review. My favorite tracks in this album are The Great Strange and Treasure in Your Hands. The Great Strange is my most favorite song in the album. I could say that this song has the catchiest tune in the entire album. Though, it's not heavy unlike the other tracks. The electronic sound brings out the party vibe, and every time I listen this track, I can't hesitate to groove and to dance. And this track is kinda reminds me of party rock anthem, which is really good and one of my favorite dance songs. Treasure in Your Hands is my next favorite song in the album. This track, what I really love most is the lyrics in the song. And it tells about trusting to someone and value of friendship. At very first when I hear this song, I cannot really understand what they're talking about. If I need to listen it multiple times and browse the lyrics on the internet. And when I browse the lyrics, I found out this song is really great. The lyricism is really great and I do appreciate so much. I really like the part tells, I cannot fight alone, not strong enough. Change yourself to trust your friends. For all we say, if you cannot change something inside of you, you should be able to walk together. Treasure is already in your hands. The value of the friendship is very important, and that's how the song tells about. Then, in terms of musicality, I could say that the song is just right on the heaviness. And I do appreciate Minami's singing style. I love the screams and the growls that he delivers on the song. The honorable mentions in the album, those are Hit the Heat and Fire Yourself Up, The Gong of Knockout, Thoughtless Words Have No Value But Just a Noise, and Where You Belong. On the song Hit the Heat and Fire Yourself Up, this intro I really love so much. The Chinese mixed electronic beat really fits my ears and it really draws my attention when I first heard it. The song is very pump up that you could mosh and dance at the same time, and you could feel the energy that they displayed when they performing it. The drums, the guitars, and the screams gives also the heaviness in the song that makes the song really great. On the song The Gong of Knockout, this song was the opening track of the 2018 anime Taiki. And I could say that they did a good job in the song. The electronic sound is way too catchy, and the heaviness is also good that you could bang your head. And the clean vocals and screams did also the good job. It's way too catchy when I'm listening from time to time. I really love the first part of the song. I really love to play it again and again. And the drum amplifies the heaviness, which is really good. There are some minor lapses in the mixing and transition, and obviously that you could hear less the guitars and the bass due to the heavy sounds of the electronic music. But all in all, this is a decent track. On the song's thoughtless words, this track is the heaviest song in the entire album. On the first seconds of the song, they bring out the heaviness pulling out from their inner selves. The screams outstand so much, as well as the hard hitting of the drums and the guitar attacks. The relentless heaviness attacks, para siyang sinasapak-sapak yung tenga mo sa bigat mong tunog eh. Pero napakaganda niya. Mapapa-headbang ka kapag pinakinggan mo siya ng paulit-ulit. And I could say that this track has a lot of catchy tunes. On the songs Where You Belong, this is the lightest tracks in my opinion, as opposed of the thoughtless words. And I do appreciate Saw's clean vocals. He outstands the most in the song. It complements the song very well, and I love the balance of the heaviness and the melodies in this song. Time for the verdict. What did I say for Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas Hypertoughness? I could rate this album as 3.5 out of 5. All in all, this album has a lot of tracks to offer, and I could say this is a decent album. I love the energy that they displayed on delivering the songs, and mahahawa ka sa kanilang energy. The songs are party and mosh pit starter, and I could say that this album is the package that metal meets electronic dance music. I'm also impressed that they come back stronger after their second bassist K died. They did a stronger album against from their previous track. Bassist Tetsuya is a worthy replacement of K. He gives out the best on the songs. Guitarist Taiki stays aggressive on his guitar plays. He gives out the ear-catchy riffs on each track. Minami's scream is really good, and in fact, he improved very well from their next streams EP. Saw's vocals displays a powerful voice, and I'm impressed. Tomonori's drumming brings out the heaviness in the songs, and the electronic dance music outstands the most. And this is the Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas staple sound. The songs had taken influence on the other electronic dance music subgenres, such as happy hardcore, eurodance, and industrial music. And I could say that they improve a lot. I'm suggesting this album for those fans of Crossfade, Passcode, IC Stars, and different Nintendo Core bands. This album fits for you. Okay, so we're already done the album review in this episode. Let me know your thoughts for Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas Hypertoughness album. Just feel free to comment it down below. And if you have an album review suggestions, then don't hesitate to comment it down below, and I'm surely entertain it. And if you like this video, don't forget to set a thumbs on my channel. It's time for the shout outs, and I would like to thank all of you for keeping supporting my channel and with all of your support from the bottom of my heart, I do really appreciate you. And shout out to Aileen Mako, classmate. Salamat sa pagsuporta sa channel ko. Hopefully, makita tayo sa pasukan, or kung hindi man, sana maging safe ka dyan sa inyo. Janine Delara, it's been a while that hindi tayo nakita dyan. Hopefully, okay kayo ng anak mo dyan. We'll see each other again soon. And support din kay Teacher Miles. We didn't see each other since the cornerstone session, and hopefully you're safe, and please support her channel also. Makikita rin niya sa links in the description. So maganda mga video contents niya. Please support her. Lastly, MH Gaming. Please support this channel. Marami siyang mga magagandang contents pagdating sa gaming. Please do like and support their FB page. Makikita rin niyo yan sa links in the description, and hopefully, supportahan niyo sila. Okay, we're done in this episode, and we'll see each other again. Again, this is Kian from the Reaper Rocker Vlog, signing off. Rock on, Pilipinas!